Elmira police officers will start seeing bigger paychecks. The city council approved a new contract with the police union. Good evening, Twin Tiers. I'm Deja Gross.
And I'm Trina Catterson. Thank you for joining us tonight at 6. It includes raises totaling 29% spread over 4 years. Not everyone voted in favor. Our 18 News reporter Nick Dubina is here with more on who raised concerns about the raises and why. Good evening, Nick.
Good evening, guys. Police departments across the country are struggling right now to recruit and retain officers. Elmira Mayor Dan Mandel says Elmira PD is competing for candidates as other police agencies are also raising salaries. Now, the pay increases were approved, but not without concerns about whether the city of Elmira can afford them.
In a 6-1 vote, the Elmira City Council approved a new 4-year contract with the union that represents Elmira police officers. It includes 2 10% pay bumps in this year and the next. Officers will see 2 more raises of 4.5% each in 2026 and 2027. That's a 29% pay increase over the life of the contract. In a statement, Police Benevolent Association President Brooke Shaw told 18 News, in part, policing has changed greatly over the past few years, and there's an increased competition for qualified individuals to become police officers. More and more departments across New York State and across America are offering higher wages, benefits, and bonus packages to attract and retain qualified candidates. This contract will assist the Elmira Police Department in remaining competitive and providing the most professional and qualified police force for the citizens of the city of Elmira. Mayor Dan Mandel agreed, saying in part, there are several officers who are planning to take offers from other agencies who are paying a much higher salary than the 2023 salaries the city was paying EPD officers. The vacancies created by several officers leaving the department would create a staffing hardship for EPD. First District Councilman Nick Grosso was the only council member to vote no. In a phone call, he told me he supports the police department, but he added a 29% increase over 4 years is something the city budget just can't afford. 4th District Councilmember Gary Brin voted to approve the deal, but only after raising several concerns. Brin said in part, our communities are overrun by assault weapons and ghost guns and narcotics. But he added in part, we may be in a hot economy, but no one is seeing these type of raises. This contract exceeds our budgeted contingency and combined with an unbudgeted overrun in healthcare costs, breaks the city's budget only 2 months into the fiscal year.
Now, some council members told us they couldn't speak on camera today because of work or family obligations. We did receive statements from other council members. To read those full statements and the contract, just go over to our website. That's mytwintiers.com. Deja.